السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر
الله أكبر الله أكبر
الله أكبر الله
الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله. إن الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير. اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين معصيتك، ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك، ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا. ومتعنا اللهم بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقواتنا ما أحييتنا، واجعله الوارث منا، واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا، وانصرنا اللهم على من عادانا، ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا، ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا، ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك ولا يرحمنا يا رب العالمين. أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم، إن زلزلة الساعة شيء عظيم. يوم ترونها تذهل كل مرضعة عما أرضعت، وتضع كل ذات حمل حملها، وترى الناس سكارى وما هم بسكارى ولكن عذاب الله شديد. وأصلي وأسلم على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين سيدنا محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه وعنا معهم، أما بعد. In the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most compassionate, the most merciful, all praise and thanks are due to him, and peace and blessings be upon his beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He who is guided by the will of Allah, no one can misguide him. And he who is misguided, no one can guide him except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alhamdulillah that we do bear witness that there is no God but Allah and Muhammad is his messenger. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, respected brothers and sisters. The title is Why the World is in Need for Islam. لماذا العالم بحاجة للإسلام؟ Why? Now, I'm standing before you today to give you like an attempt to understand why. The question, now, we are witnessing a horrible thing that happens now in Palestine. We are witnessing ethnic cleansing, genocide, killing, direct. The social media played an amazing role in making things direct, clear by seconds. Yet, we can see big number, the majority of politicians, leaders, people of authority around the world, simply they don't care. Is this true or not? So what could come to the mind? Simple question, why? If they, now in theory, most of them, I will not say all, claim that they support truth, they support reality, they support human rights, but on ground, the majority of them, they don't care, as I said, they don't care about, you know, what's happening, they don't care about the falsehood, they follow the falsehood, they support dictatorship, they are accepting the murderers and killing. It's a question, it's intellectual question. I'm trying to find one of the possible answers from Islamic point of view, why this happens. You as Muslims need to understand, because sometimes this is called Zahira. This is a phenomenon. This is something happens. You see realities. You see clear killing, ethnic cleansing, and murder. And you see people claim something, yet they do nothing. What's happening? Why? Let's go with a quick journey with one of the great intellectuals of the last century, Abu al-Hasan al-Nadwi. Abu al-Hasan al-Nadwi and Abu al-A'la al-Mawdudi, they are one of the two great scholars of the subcontinent of Muslims in India and Pakistan. Okay, when they were still, Pakistan did not exist. So, because you know, Pakistan and Bangladesh, they were split and separated from Islamic India for 1,000 years after the British came. Many people, maybe they don't know. It was just Muslims of India. Anyway, Abu al-Hasan al-Nadwi wrote a book, one of the greatest book of his books. It's called Mada Khasir al-Alam bin Hitat al-Muslimin. And I urge Arabs to read it, and it's in English and whatever, but I was reading in Arabic. The title of is What Has the World Lost by the Decline of Muslims? Not Islam. Islam will not be declined. But Muslims, they go down, ups, downs. We have good Muslims, bad times, good times. We follow, we leave, we are punished, you know, ups and downs. So he's putting a question, what has the world lost by the decline of Muslims? If I'm not mistaken, he wrote this book around 1947-48. It was published in 1950-something. So when he wrote this book, still America that we know did not exist with its power. And that's why he's talking about Europe. Because at that time, still, one of the greatest power it was, it used to be Britain, France, Italy, okay? These Europeans. So that's why he was talking about, in this book, he went through the history and he spoke about, you know, Indian culture, Chinese culture, Greek culture, Roman culture, European culture, Judeo-Christian culture, Islamic culture. So when he came to nowadays Europe, one of the notable things that he noticed that Europe used to be a Greek or Roman culture, then Judeo-Christian culture. So he was talking about that this place of the world, which is Europe in his time, basically one of the basic pillars of their beliefs is materialism and power. Madda, materialism. Spirituality, even though when they were a Greek and Romans, they used to have gods. Please focus on this. Yes, multi-gods for many things. You know, multi-gods, Greek and Romans. But those gods just for the temple, not for the life. They, for example, the Greek people, which is one of the origins, the oldest origins of Europeans, they say they used to worship God in the temple and for one day, and 6 days they used to make plays in the theater making fun of God, which means God is just a nice spiritual idea for sometimes, but God has no interference in their business, which is exactly what the mushrikeen of Mecca used to do. وَلَئِنْ سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ يَقُولُونَ اللَّهِ. If you ask them who created heavens and earth, they would say Allah. طيب, Do you allow this Allah, this God to interfere in your economy? No, no, Habibi. We decide how to run our life. Riba, this God says riba is haram. No, 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 no. Muhammad, لو سمحت, out. We manage our life. We believe in God, but God is just there. When we want to speak about him, we speak about him. But if he said zina haram, riba haram, no, 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 no. He has no right. By this, they became kuffar. So this, generally, he was discussing these ideas. So he came to a point. I will be quoting and rephrasing from some of his words. He was talking about Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad in chapter called Aspects of Materialistic Nature in Europe. This book 75 years ago. I will quote with rephrasing. Then I will send my message. The title is Why the World is in Need for Islam. Why the world is in need. Because every time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is showing us the application of the great ayah, سَنُرِيهِمْ آيَاتِنَا فِي الْآفَاقِ وَفِي أَنفُسِهِمْ حَتَّى يَتَبَيَّنَ لَهُمْ أَنَّهُ الْحَقِّ أَوَلَمْ يَكْفِ بِرَبِّكَ أَنَّهُ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ شَهِيدٍ. We will show them, and Allah did not say show you Muhammad or you Arabs, Muslims, show them, others. We will keep showing them our signs, our greatness, our glory in the horizons and in themselves. Every time they keep facing the troubles, witness, this is the truth. To know that this is the haq. What is the haq now? The Quran and Islam. It is the haq. Now Abul Hassan says in this chapter, which is Aspects of Materialistic Nature in Europe. He says, those people, he's talking about Europeans at that time, 75 years ago, who do not believe in another life and don't believe in any high goal, focus now, they don't believe in any high goal beyond physical pleasure, enjoying worldly life and gaining superiority on earth. They don't mention God except in the rare occasions, and they don't hold any real respect for God, and they don't seek refuge in him. And by the way, when I was reading, they don't respect God. I spent 6 years in the UK, 25 years ago, doing my PhD. One of the jokes that I learned in the streets of there, from the people, from British people that I knew, it's a very common joke. They say, 25 years ago, not now. They used to say, easily you could stop any British in the street and ask him, excuse me, sir, are you a Christian? Yes. Do you go to the church? Yes. Do you believe in God? No. This is a joke. Are you a Christian? Yes. Do you go to the church? Yes. Do you believe in God? No. Which means it's like an indirect joke to tell you that religion is just a tradition. The majority, they don't believe, which is the case, by the way, even for many Muslims now, which is the case. Materialism now is the God of many people. But you need to understand, what does it mean? What does it mean, materialism? He's saying now, they don't believe in another life, don't believe in any high goal. There is nothing called al-akhirah, the hereafter. There is nothing called accountability. There is nothing called superiority for another power in another life, which means everything is here. If everything is here, so they don't believe in any high goal beyond physical pleasure, enjoying life and gaining superiority on earth. So they don't mention God except in rare occasions, and they don't hold any real respect, any real, because some respect, yes, as long as it does not go against my interest, okay, I will respect this God, which is exactly what the mushrikeen in Mecca used to do. That's why they came to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam when they asked him before the revelation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا الْكَافِرُونَ لَا أَعْبُدُ مَا تَعْبُدُونَ وَلَا أَنْتُمْ. Why? Because they came to him. He say, look, Muhammad, please, now, for us, you are a troublemaker. You are just causing destruction in the society. Why not to make it half-half? One day you worship our gods, next day we worship your God, 50-50. It's a very childish, idiot, stupid way in faith. But simply, it does not go that way. What do you mean with God? It's a full system. its superiority. حاكم, it's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator. Everything should go to him. That's why Allah says, قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا say, قُلْ لَهُمْ لَا أَعْبُدُ مَا تَعْبُدُونَ, I don't worship, which means I don't obey what you believe. Because other ideologies, they are other gods. Other gods. Now, he continues. I'm quoting and rephrasing because I'm translating. He continues, by depending on materialistic aspects, they reach to the level of declaring that they don't need God. And by the way, there is an American author, I forgot his name now, it was in my mind. He wrote a book about it 25 years ago called The Death of God in America. Now, the core idea of the book, he said 25 years ago, he said, we reached the moon. We are able through the online now to do a lot of things. Even we do surgical operations, you know, remotely. Why should we be meet to this God? We are so advanced to a degree that there is no need for God. Therefore, he wrote with all kind of rude attitude, a book, The Death of God, which means we don't need to God anymore. Now, by depending on materialistic, they reach to the level of declaring that they don't need God. They have reached a level of cruelty and negligence to a degree that the following ayah is applicable on them. Still, I'm just reading what Abu al-Hasan al-Nadwi says in his book. He says, he quoted this ayah. He said, this ayah is applicable on them. وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا إِلَى أُمَمٍ مِّن قَبْلِكَ فَأَخَذْنَاهُمْ بِالْبَأْسَاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَضَرَّعُونَ. Indeed, we have sent messengers before you, O Prophet, O Muhammad, to other people who we put through suffering and adversity for their denial, so perhaps they would be humbled. Part of the law of Allah, universal law of Allah, when some people, they go outside the track, Allah let them suffer so that they humble themselves, they come back to Allah, which is the general law of Allah for individuals, groups, societies, communities, ummah, the same thing, all of us. Sometimes Allah punishes us as individuals out of his mercy. But it's like saying, hey, know your place, be careful. You are about to do more. It's simple punishment. I want to do something haram. I was screaming in the face of my mother. I was watching porno sites. I was. Just a simple virus called corona. 10 days on bed. I was literally not able to do anything. So as if Allah is telling me, know your place, be careful. It's just a reminder. It's just like, be careful. So Allah applies this same on societies as well and on nations. So وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا إِلَىٰ أُمَمٍ مِّن قَبْلِكَ. Indeed, we've sent messengers before you, O Prophet, to other people who we put through suffering and adversity for their denial, so perhaps they would be humbled. فَلَوْلَا إِذْ جَاءَهُمْ بَأْسُنَا تَضَرَّعُوا وَلَكِنْ قَسَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ وَزَيَّنَ لَهُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. Why did they not humble themselves when we made them suffer? Instead, their hearts were hardened and Satan made their misdeeds appealing to them. So Allah was pushing, come to me. They hardened their hearts. We don't want. We don't want. We don't want. Then Shaitan was able to make their misdeeds appealing to them. Okay, you are doing the good. By being superior, by enslaving a full continent, killing 200 million Africans. It's good. It's nothing. We are benefiting them. We are giving them civil society. But you are killing 200 millions. We are benefiting them. The rest day, no need for them. You see? وَزَيَّنَ لَهُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ مَا كَانُ. What is colonialism? You leave your place, you go to another place, you kill, you control, you seize everything, and still you feel superior that you are benefiting them. What kind of rude attitude is this? وَزَيَّنَ لَهُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ مَا كَانُ يَعْمَلُونَ. And Satan made their misdeeds appealing to them. Now I'm continuing. It's his words. Hardly you feel in the speeches of their leaders and tenderness of the heart.
Hardly you feel in the speeches of their leaders the tenderness of the heart or the brokenness of the heart and its refuge in God. In the most difficult times of wars, because he wrote this in the mid of the Second World War, because people on the globe, they were suffering. Second World War, 52 millions they were killed without mass destruction weapons. And by the way, Hiroshima and Nagasaki hardly both killed less than 250,000. At that time, they were not advanced. They killed just around less than 250,000, both bombs. The majority with the classical way of killing, 52 millions. Mainly, you know, Germany, Nazism of Germany, fascism of Italy, and France and Britain, and they were, you know, they did 52 millions. Can you? I mean, no one can imagine this number. They were killed in 6 years. 52 million, 6 years, with about 8 to 9 million a year. Which means every month, about 900,000. I mean, something unimaginable. This happened 75 years ago. So that's why he say, at times of wars, God, in the most difficult times of wars, neither you see these aspects in the general behavior of the people. And when you see what are the general causes that the majority of people look at when sacrificing themselves and their souls, mainly it goes back to materialistic goals. He says, even at time of wars, suffering, people are dying. Dying for what? Sacrificing for what? He's analyzing now. Analyzing a phenomena he witnessed 75 years ago. He say, such as, for example, they are sacrificing, dying. They do it for the sake of materialistic goals, such as good reputation, being famous, immorality in history, خلود الذكر في التاريخ, superiority above others, the glorification of his people and the glory of his country, الوطن. نموت ليحيى الوطن. Does that ring a bell in your minds, in our countries, our leaders? What is the وطن? وثن الوطن, the idol of وطن. حبيبي, Allah is much more important. Dignity is much more important than the piece of land, unless if Allah decided to make it sacred. So he's talking about such a good reputation, being famous, immorality in history, superiority above others, the glorification of his people, the fact of the one who's sacrificing himself, and the glory of his country. Unlike those who do these things for the sake of God Almighty. As true believers, do these things for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they are always afraid from the cancellation or deletion or destruction of his work of their works. They listen to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, قُلْ هَلْ نُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِالْأَخْسَرِينَ أَعْمَالًا. Say, O Prophet, shall we inform you of who will be the biggest losers of deeds? الَّذِينَ ضَلَّ سَعْيُهُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَهُمْ يَحْسَبُونَ أَنَّهُمْ يُحْسِنُونَ صُنْعًا. They are doing deeds. They claim we are doing the good, but in reality, قال يحسبون أنهم يحسنون ضل سعيهم. They are those whose efforts are in vain in this worldly life, while they think they are good, doing good. أولئك الذين كفروا. I'm still quoting what he wrote. أولئك الذين كفروا بآيات ربهم ولقائه فحبطت أعمالهم فلا نقيم لهم يوم القيامة وزنا. It is they who reject the signs of their Lord. And by the way, this is applicable to anyone who supports this cause. Anyone, any politician, any writer, any journalist, any influencer, any social media, any TikToker, any whatever, support this is part. It is they who reject the signs of their Lord, signs of our Lord, ayati rabbihim, to see clearly the haq, to see who is the what is justice. You are witnessing by nature, you understand it. When you decide to reject, you will be with the other side, with the wrong side of the equation. It is they who reject. And by the way, rejection is one of the meanings of kufr. Well, kufr means to cover. And I always said it many, many times. I will repeat it maybe for the time 100. Now, I need to hold something to make it clear for the kids. Now, example to know, the word kafara in Arabic, kufur, from the word cover in English. So the word cover in English has been taken from kafara in Arabic, which means to cover. Literally, it means to cover. Now the example, why do we call the kafir kafir? What's the relation between the kafir who rejected the truth with the original meaning of covering? What's the relation? Now, when you go to the lexicons, to the dictionaries, now I'm holding, for example, the keys, my keys, or the key of my car. If I ask someone, am I holding? Yes. If someone is asking me, Amjad, do you hold your keys? Am I holding my keys? Yes or no? Type. If someone asks me, Amjad, do you hold your keys? And I said, no. Excuse me. Do you hold your keys? No. Excuse me. Do you hold your keys? أقسم بالله, no. I'm doing the act of kufr now, which is, I know that I'm hiding and covering the truth, claiming otherwise. This is the kufr. The kufr means, وَجَحَدُوا بِهَا وَاسْتَيْقَنَتْهَا أَنفُسُهُمْ ظُلْمًا وَعُلُوًّا. They realized it for certain, but they rejected it. This is the kufr. So you need to understand what's the meaning, the terminology. قال, it is they who reject the signs of their Lord and their meeting with Him, rendering their deeds void. So we will not give their deeds any weight on Judgment Day. And قول الله عز وجل, he quoted أبو الحسن الندوي, وَقَدِمْنَا إِلَى مَا عَمِلُوا مِنْ عَمَلٍ فَجَعَلْنَاهُ هَبَاءً مَنْثُورًا. Then we will turn to whatever good deeds they did, reducing them to scattered dust. The good deeds in the footnotes of Khattab, Mustafa Khattab, say the good deeds of the disbelievers like charity will have no weight on Judgment Day, nothing at all. Now, this was the part of what I quoted from him, just to give you an idea what's happening, why. Simply a group of people on earth, when he wrote this, he was talking a specific location. Now, this is applicable on many different parts of the world, including the majority of our leaders and our regimes and our politicians. They are in the same way of thinking. So I talk about an idea. Why? Simply they decided to worship themselves, their interests, their superiority. So for them, they don't care. It's not they don't know, they don't care. Because you as a believer, what do you care for basically? Your priority is your Lord. Not you don't love, for example, in theory, would you love to have 10 houses, each one of them with 3 millions? Yes. Can you have them easily through riba? Maybe. Maybe very easy. But riba is haram, so you will stop. So your desire says this, but you will stop it. In theory now, God forbid. If zina is not haram, can any man claim that sexual desire is not a very nice thing? Can anyone challenge me? No. You all, why do we marry? Why do we marry? Why would you get married? But zina is haram. This channel is haram. But it's very appealing for the self. But it's haram. It's not we don't like it. We like it, but we don't do it. So this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is testing us. Now, أقول قبل هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فيا فوز المستغفرين. إن الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا, من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا, وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له, له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير. Let's now continue the equation. Now, according to Abu al-Hasan al-Nadwi, one of the main reasons as an attempt to analyze why people of power, leaders, politicians, they don't care even though they don't know, simply they are worshipping something else. Themselves, their interest, their desire, simply they know, but they don't care. So when you care about the Creator, you will be saved. If you don't care, this is what you do. Just is analysis to know why they don't care. Now, to see the importance of Islam now. This is the side, which is the materialistic aspect. On the other aspects, in Islam, And in Christianity, we have some, I don't generalize, aspects about Sufism. I don't generalize, I repeat. I'm not saying every order of Sufism is bad, but however, we have a very, very bad Sufi orders, which take about the other side of the coin. We have materialism of the West, and we have some kind of spiritual Sufism or mysticism or monasticism, zuhud, tasawwuf, rahbana, all of these things, we have it. Those groups, I'm concerned in Muslims now because they have it, they do have it in Judaism and Christianity as well. But let's talk about Muslims now. We have it in the other side. Historically, politicians, people of power and authority, they love very much people to be following Sufi orders in general. Why? Because they are disconnected from life. What does it mean? They don't interfere in anything. Just they go to the corner. So politicians, they love. That's why, for example, the think tank, one of the biggest, most influential center of think tank reports on earth, which is RAND. RAND, since many years, they wrote, this center helps the big politicians in America to decide how to deal with our countries. One of their biggest aims now to spread Sufism in our countries. Why the reason? Because if you became a very dedicated Sufi, you will do what? You will not care about anything politicians they do about your life. You go there, just keep doing tasbih and doing and pray and ask your sheikh, kiss his hand and sit and alhamdulillah, everything is okay. No politicians, yes, yes, no, yes. No, you know, so we have this materialistic and we have this aspect alone in the world. But what is the true real Islam? I finish my talk just to give an idea because it's a Jum'ah prayer. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I will give you an ayah and a hadith. Just fix it in your mind. And if your kids did not understand part of my words, please explain it to them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَاكُمْ أُمَّةً وَسَطًا لِتَكُونُوا شُهَدَاءَ عَلَى النَّاسِ Not عَلَى Muslims. وَيَكُونَ الرَّسُولُ عَلَيْكُمْ شَهِيدًا And so we have made you believers an upright, moderate, balanced, and outstanding community so that you may be witness over humanity. You Muslims, but as a role model, by applying Islam, you are the role model, you are the criterion for humanity of good and bad, and right and wrong. This is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking. In every aspect, political aspect, international politics, finance, money, there should be an example to people say, oh, look, when they apply the Islamic system, there is zero interest. We will not be enslaved for banks. When they do not commit zina, I know who's my kid, and my kid knows who's his father. When they prohibit alcohol, drugs, and porno, and trafficking, or human trafficking, we enjoy all the time not to lose our kids, or to destroy or kill each other by this way. Oh, this is a real example. This is the meaning of أُمَّةَ وَسَطَ تَكُونُ شُهَدَاءَ You will be like a criterion standard. Others should witness you and follow your footsteps. This is the meaning. Now, and so we have made you believers, all believers, and upright, i.e. moderate, balanced, and outstanding community, so that you may be witness over humanity, and that the messenger may be a witness over you. And the last thing, that I'll send to you, the very well-known hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's hadith muttafaq alayhi, it was narrated by Bukhari and Muslim. I will narrate it by the meaning very quickly. Ja'a thalathatu rahtin ila Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Falam yakun mawjudan. Sa'alu anhu, faqal fasa'alu an ibadatihi. Faka'annahum taqalluha. Three people from outside the Medina came to ask, you want to ask Prophet about something. They did not find him. So they asked, you know, the family of Prophet Muhammad, the very close people around him, about his act of worship. What his ritual worship. When they listened what he do, كَأَنَّهُمْ تَقَالُّوهَا They felt as if it's little compared with what they do. قَالْ أَمَّا أَحَدُهُمْ One of them, he said, as for me, قال فأنا أقوم الليل ولا أنام Every day I have قيام compared with Prophet Muhammad because they knew that he does not do the قيام every day. قال تقالوها They felt as if it's little compared with what they do. قال The second one قال وأما أنا فأصوم الدهر As for me I fast every day. Third one قال وأما أنا فلا أتزوج النساء As for me I do not marry I don't touch the woman as if it's, you know, something prohibited. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam came later. He was told what those three stranger visitors, guests said. Then he came to them. قال أين الذين, where are those who said such and such? He repeated what they say. قال as for me, look now, he is fixing the standard now for us to be witness for humanity. قال as for me, أما أنا فأقوم وأنام. I sleep, I enjoy my normal physical pleasures, needs, and I do qiyam. قال وأصوم وأفطر. I fast sometimes and I enjoy breaking the fast sometimes. وأتزوج النساء and I do marry. I enjoy myself with the halal sexual relation. قال فمن رغب عن سنتي فليس مني. He whoever decides to go outside the track of my sunnah, قال فليس مني. He is not following me. It's his own sunnah, his own way. Don't claim that this is the prophet. This is the wasatiyya. Now, because humanity is not applying such a methodology and a policy, they are doing what they are doing. This is the idea. That's why the title of my khutbah, why the world is in need for Islam. I'm addressing the new generations, youth. If you want what happens in Palestine and Gaza not to be repeated, you need to spread Islam. This is the answer. The reason why we have this kind of injustice, because simply majority of people, they don't know Allah, they don't care about Allah. When they know and care, the whole equation will change. So we have a long, long way to go. This is not the end of the story. This is one of the phases of a long, long conflict between haqq and batil, falsehood and truth. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فيا فوز المستغفرين. اللهم ارحمنا فوق الأرض وتحت الأرض ويوم العرض عليك يا كريم. اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا ووالد والدينا واصحاب الحقوق والواجبات علينا يا كريم. اللهم إنا عبيدك أبناء عبيدك أبناء إمائك نواصينا بيدك ماض فينا حكمك عدل فينا قضاؤك. نسألك بكل اسم هو لك سميت به نفسك أو أنزلته في كتابك أو علمته أحدا من خلقك أو استأثرت به في علم الغيب عندك أن تجعل القرآن العظيم ربيع قلوبنا وجلاء أحزاننا وذهاب همومنا وغمومنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم تقبل شهداءهم يا رب العالمين وداوي جرحاهم واشف مرضاهم واخذل من خذلهم وانتقم ممن طعنهم يا الله يا رب العالمين. واغفر لنا تقصيرنا وتجاوز عنا وارحم والدينا ووالدي والدينا واصحاب الحقوق والواجبات علينا يا كريم. اللهم اغسلهم بالماء والثلج والبرد ونقهم من الذنوب والخطايا والآثام كما ينقى الثوب الأبيض من الدنس. ارحمنا يا الله يا كريم. اغفر لنا يا الله يا حي يا قيوم يا حنان يا منان يا عفو يا غفور يا ودود يا حليم يا رب العالمين. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. وأقم الصلاة.